Now we are going to see the lateral spinothalamic tract and anterior spinothalamic tract one by one. Break the name lateral because it will run on the lateral white column from spinal cord to the thalamus. Means again it is the example of ascending tract. Okay, so first of all, what is the function of the lateral spinothalamic tract? Yes, LSTT. It is responsible for the pain and temperature. So this question have been asked many times. First of all, try to understand what is the function of the lateral spinothalamic tract and anterior spinothalamic tract. Lateral spinothalamic tract is responsible for the pain and temperature sensation from the opposite half of the body, while anterior spinothalamic tract, it is responsible for the crude touch sensation, again from the opposite half of the body. Both are very important MCQ, asked many time in PG medical entrance exams as well as Viva question. Okay, so now one by one, first we are going to deal with the lateral spinothalamic tract. So first we draw the basic diagram for any tract. सबसे पहले हमें बनाना है सेरेब्रल कॉर्टेक्स, देन वी हैव टू मेक द पॉन्स, मिडब्रेन, पॉन्स एंड देन मेडुला, देन स्पाइनल कॉर्ड. फॉर द सिमेट्री ऑफ द डायग्राम वी आर गोइंग टू ड्रॉ वन मिड लाइन. सपोज दिस इज द सेरेब्रल कॉर्टेक्स, वेरियस सल्काई गायराई इन द कोरोनल सेक्शन. On the deeper side of the brain, there is the location of the thalamus. Now, below to this cerebral hemisphere, there is a location of the midbrain. Diagrammatic presentation, midbrain. This is the pons, and here is the medulla. The pons and the medulla on the posterior aspect related with the cerebellum. Suppose this is a cerebellum, diagrammatic presentation. Now at the lower side, suppose these are the two segments of the spinal cord. So dorsal horn and the ventral horn, diagrammatic presentation. Suppose this is the spinal cord. For the proper understanding, we are again drawing one more spinal cord segment. What is the spinal cord segment? Yes, the part of the spinal cord with the a pair of sensory root and a pair of motor root, that is known as spinal segment. Okay, here are the various labeling for the proper knowledge. Suppose this is the sensory area, or you can say cortex, specifically area number 312 we will mention. This part is indicating the thalamus. Here is the midbrain. This structure is showing pons. This dilatation is showing medulla. Means these all the three structures are brain stem. Here is little brain, cerebellum, and these are the spinal segment, spinal cord. Now see, pain and temperature pathway first we are going to discuss. Suppose this is the hot coffee, then it is causing the stimulation of the peripheral nerve. Thanda garam ka sensation kaise lagta hai wo hum dekh rahe hain. Yes, this is a stimulation of the pain and temperature receptor. Temperature receptor, as you know, Ruffini's end organ, Krauss's bulb, this all. Okay, so these receptors are getting stimulation. Now they are going towards the spinal cord. Because these are sensation, that's why they will take entry from the dorsal horn part. So when it is coming here, it is relaying in the dorsal root ganglion, which is the classical example of pseudo unipolar neuron, MCQ. then it is taking entry inside the dorsal horn and it is ending here into a particular nucleus. So what is the name of that nucleus? Try to understand. Yes, the nucleus which is located here, that is a substantia gelatinosa nucleus. Okay, very most important, various MCQ have been asked. I told you in Raxad lamina part. Now the fiber from this substantia gelatinosa nucleus, they are crossing the spinal cord just in front of the central canal. Remember, this is very important point to correlate with one clinical situation, that is the syringomyelia. So syphilis ek disease hoti hai, usme S for syphilis, S for syringomyelia, usme abnormal dilatation of central canal ho jata hai. So syphilis causes abnormal dilatation of this central canal, that will damage this lateral spinothalamic tract. Okay, so now the fibers are running just in front of the central canal and then they are reaching in front of, try to understand, it is reaching in front of the spinal cord, but they are not relaying, they are not going, they are crossing the midline and they are going to the opposite side, and now they are making the bundle of axon. So again I am using the green color. Yes, here is one bundle of axon. Here brown color, yellow color is single fiber, but this green color is showing the various bundles of the axons. Now from here the nerve will run upside. Again single fiber we are showing, and these all the fibers are making the bundle of axons on the lateral side of the spinal cord. Yes, these bundle of the axon is present on the lateral side, that's why lateral. It is running from spinal cord and it is going towards the thalamus, that's why spinothalamic bundle of axon, that's why tract. Okay, now these all the fibers are running above, then these are reaching and crossing the medulla, then crossing the pons, then crossing the midband. Getting the point? They are crossing the medulla, they are crossing the pons, and then they are crossing the midband, and ultimately this all the fibers are reaching into the thalamus. And now from this thalamus part, one another neuron is arising, and then these fibers are reaching to the sensory cortex area, area number 312. Complete. Okay, so this is the course, origin, course and termination of the lateral spinothalamic tract. You can see here the first order neuron. Yes, this is dorsal root ganglion. Okay, so the first order neuron, it is from dorsal root ganglion to that nucleus. What is the name of this nucleus? Substantia gelatinosa nucleus. Yes, this is known as substantia gelatinosa nucleus, which is related with the pain and temperature pathway, located at Raxad lamina 2, and this Raxad lamina 2 is totally unmyelinated. These are the three different MCQs which have been asked. Okay, so the first order neuron is from dorsal root ganglion to the substantia gelatinosa nucleus. So this is the one viva question. Now the second order neuron, this brown color structure is showing the second order neuron. You can say by the image that second order neuron is from substantia gelatinosa nucleus to up to the thalamus. So this is the another viva as well as MCQ. Now the third order neuron, yes, this yellow color structure is showing the third order neuron. Yes, from thalamus to cortex. So this is one another question for you. So this is the lateral spinothalamic tract. Because it is running from the lateral side of the spinal cord up to the thalamus, that's why lateral spinothalamic tract. Getting the point? Okay, now see here, it is the example of the crossed tract. So try to understand, if there is the lesion at this part or any part, this is the example of ascending tract. So loss of sensation is on this side. Such kind of the phenomena is known as contralateral. Means agar chot right side lag rahi hai, लेकिन लॉस ऑफ सेंसेशन ऑपोजिट साइड में हो रहा है, तो इसे हम कहते हैं कॉन्ट्रालेटर। यस, हियर द लीजन इज ऑन द लेफ्ट साइड बट दिस पाथवे इज कमिंग फ्रॉम द राइट साइड, सो द राइट साइड पेन एंड टेम्परेचर पार्ट विल बी लॉस्ट, सो दिस इज नोन एज कॉन्ट्रालेटरल। रिमेंबर, क्रॉस्ड ट्रैक्ट, कॉन्ट्रालेटरल सिम्टम्स। ओके, सो दिस इज वन वे हाउ कैन यू रिमेंबर। नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द एंटीरियर स्पाइनोथैलेमिक ट्रैक्ट। एंटीरियर क्यों कह रहे हैं? बिकॉज इट विल रन फ्रॉम द एंटीरियर साइड ऑफ द स्पाइनल कॉर्ड, इट विल रन फ्रॉम द स्पाइनल कॉर्ड टू द थैलेमस, दैट्स व्हाई स्पाइनोथैलेमिक बंडल ऑफ एक्सॉन, दैट्स व्हाई ट्रैक्ट। गेटिंग द पॉइंट? इसका फंक्शन क्या है हम देख चुके हैं। क्रूड टच सेंसेशन। व्हाट इज द क्रूड टच सेंसेशन? यस, एग्जैक्ट पिन पॉइंट लोकलाइजेशन। आंख बंद करेंगे और पिन को अगर हम अलग अलग पार्ट में चुभाते हैं तो पेशेंट जो होता है एग्जैक्ट पॉइंट बताता है, दैट इज नोन एज द पिन पॉइंट एग्जैक्ट लोकलाइजेशन, टैक्टाइल लोकलाइजेशन। बट वॉट इज अ क्रूड टच? डिफ्यूज टच। जैसे कि हम कपड़े पहने हुए हैं तो कपड़े का सेंसेशन पूरे बॉडी में है, हम शूज पहने हुए हैं तो शूज का सेंसेशन हमारे पैरों में है। यस, इफ वी आर सिटिंग ऑन द चेयर सो वी आर हैविंग द सेंसेशन ऑफ द चेयर ऑन द थाई, ऑन द बैक साइड। सो दिस ऑल आर द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ द क्रूड टच। ओके, तो ये पाथवे कैसे रन करता है? यस, सी हियर, बिकॉज इट इज द टच सेंसेशन सो अगेन रिसेप्टर्स विल बी द टच रिसेप्टर। तो यहां से एग्जॉन्स जो है निकले, ओके, बट दीज आर नॉट द पार्ट ऑफ द ट्रैक्ट, क्योंकि ट्रैक्ट जो होता है वो स्पाइनल कॉर्ड के अंदर टर्म यूज होता है। सो नाउ दे आर मेकिंग द डॉर्सल रूट गैंग्लियन, अगेन द सेम रूल, बिकॉज दिस इज द सेंसरी नर्व, दैट्स वाई इट विल टेक एंट्री विद इन द स्पाइनल कॉर्ड थ्रू द आवर डॉर्सल हॉर्न। ओके, सो दिस डॉर्सल रूट गैंग्लियन इज कमिंग टू द स्पाइनल कॉर्ड। नाउ सी हियर, when it is reaching inside the spinal cord it is relaying into a particular nucleus, this nucleus is known as nucleus proprius, so from the dorsal root ganglion up to the nucleus proprius, okay, this is first order neuron, so here you have to make one nucleus, and remember now this axon is directly going to the front part because it is anterior spinothalamic tract, that's why now the bundle of axon is formed on the anterior side. Okay, so here there is a formation of anterior spinothalamic tract. Okay, so what I want to tell you, you can write down, this is dorsal root ganglion and here this nucleus, red color large mass on the dorsal horn is showing the nucleus proprius, where at dorsal horn. Getting the point? And now this form bundle is the anterior spinothalamic tract, anteriorly in the spinal cord, and now it will run to the thalamus. How? Try to understand. Now the axons are running anteriorly, and yes, what you have to remember that these fibers are away from the central canal, while the lateral spinothalamic tract was very close to the central canal. That's why if there is a dilatation of the central canal, there will be the damage of the lateral spinothalamic tract, but anterior spinothalamic tract will not damage. So, is karan se patient mein ek type ka sensation loss hoga, pain and temperature ka loss hoga, while the touch receptor, touch sensation will remain normal. तो ऐसे लॉस ऑफ सेंसेशन को हम डिसोसिएटिव एनेस्थेसिया कहते हैं। वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एमसीक्यू, वी विल सी लेटर। ओके, नाउ दिस ट्रैक्ट इज रनिंग अपसाइड एंड मेकिंग द बंडल ऑन द फ्रंट ऑफ द स्पाइनल कॉर्ड। ओके, सो इट इज रनिंग अपसाइड। नाउ इट इज रनिंग फ्रॉम द स्पाइनल कॉर्ड, देन इट इज रीचिंग इन टू द मेडुला, देन नाउ इट इज क्रॉसिंग द पॉन्स, देन इट इज क्रॉसिंग द मिडब्रेन, then it is reaching to the thalamus, and here in the thalamus it is ending. So this is the second order neuron, from nucleus proprius up to the thalamus, second order neuron. Now another neuron will arise. Can you see here? From the thalamus another neuron is originating and it is going to the cortex, sensory area, area number 312. So this is the third order neuron. So what I want to tell you, yes, you can write down for your notes, first order neuron from dorsal root ganglion to nucleus proprius, one viva and MCQ question, this yellow color nerve is the first order neuron. Now this red color nerve is showing the second order neuron. These neurons are not running as a single nerve. ये टूट टूट के जाते हैं, एक नर्व दूसरे में रिले करता है, दूसरा नर्व तीसरे में रिले करता है. सो दिस सेगमेंट्स ऑफ द नर्व्स आर नोन एज ऑर्डर ऑफ न्यूरॉन. ओके, इट इज रनिंग फ्रॉम न्यूक्लियस प्रोप्रियस टू थैलेमस एंड हियर इज अ थर्ड ऑर्डर न्यूरॉन फ्रॉम थैलेमस टू cortex. Okay, so in this way this tract is running. Now try to understand, lateral spinothalamic tract is also very close to this anterior spinothalamic tract. Agar hum dono fibers ko, dono tract ko ek saath banaye, then we will see, yes, in the pons and the midbrain part they are running very closely. So this bundle of two tract combinedly known as spinal lemniscus. So this is the MCQ. Spinal lemniscus is equal to lateral spinothalamic tract plus anterior spinothalamic tract. So this MCQ is asked in many types of the exams as well as viva question. So this is the course origin, course termination and function of the tract. What is the function? Crude touch sensation. Now we are going to see the applied part of this lateral spinothalamic tract and anterior spinothalamic tract, that is a syringomyelia. Try to understand, as you can see this image, what is the meaning of the syringomyelia? Syringo, syrinx means dilatation. Few books will mention cystic dilatation. Okay, where whenever there is a term myelo, myelo means spinal cord related. So actually in this disease, yes, it is related with many disorder, but one of the cause is the syphilis. So what I want to tell you, yes, applied part due to the treponema pallidum infection in microbiology. Yes, this is the microbiology correlation. Okay, yes, you will see that there is the one spirochete. Treponema pallidum, it causes infection and causes the syphilis, which is the one of the example of the sexual transmitted disease. It causes many disorders, just like it causes the Tabish dorsalis, which we have seen, where there is the damage to dorsal column tract, and we know the dorsal column tract means fasciculus gracilis and the fasciculus cuneatus. Fasciculus gracilis and fasciculus cuneatus, these are damaged. So there is the loss of related function. But now see, here we are going to see that this syphilis also causes one disease, that is a syringomyelia. So we are going to see this syringomyelia due to the syphilis. S for syphilis, S for syringomyelia. It may occur. There are other causes also, but here we are focusing over this syphilis and syringomyelia relation. Okay, so what happens in this is, yes, there is the abnormal dilatation of central canal of spinal cord. So due to this abnormal dilatation, there is the damage to lateral spinothalamic tract, but anterior spinothalamic tract remains intact. There is no damage. Why? See here diagrammatic presentation. Suppose this is the central canal, this is the dorsal horn and the ventral horn, dorsal horn and the ventral horn. Okay, and you have seen that lateral spinothalamic tract is coming dorsal root ganglion, from the dorsal root ganglion, then it is ending at the substantia gelatinosa nucleus. Then these pathway are crossing from the front of the central canal, then these fibers are reaching on the lateral side and making the bundle of axon on the lateral side. So this is the lateral spinothalamic tract, and now the axons are running upside in this way. Okay, while the anterior spinothalamic tract, using the yellow color, yes, Again, these fibers are coming from the dorsal root ganglion and relaying. But the name of the nucleus is nucleus propius, and these fibers are away from the central canal. And also it is written in textbooks that anterior spinothalamic tract crosses the spinal cord, crosses the midline, one or two segment above. Suppose this is the image of the L2 vertebral level. So the lateral spinothalamic tract is crossing the midline, okay, at the same spinal segment level. But the anterior spinothalamic tract, it crosses the midline of the spinal cord one or two segment above. Means if we are talking L2 level, so lateral spinothalamic tract will cross the midline at the same L2 level. But anterior spinothalamic tract, it will ascend and it will cross the midline either at L1 or at the level of the T12 level. Means this indicates that anterior spinothalamic tract is away from the lateral spinothalamic tract as well as central canal. Okay, so it is reaching on the front and it is making the bundle of axon on the anterior side. Now these fibers are running upward from the anterior side. So what I want to tell you, yes, this is the pathway for the lateral spinothalamic tract, this is the pathway for the anterior spinothalamic tract. This bundle of the axon is showing the lateral spinothalamic tract, this bundle of axon is showing the anterior spinothalamic tract. Okay, suppose this is the shape of the spinal cord. Now try to understand, if there is the dilatation of the central canal, can you see if it is getting dilatation? So which tract is getting damaged? Yes, you can see this lateral spinothalamic tract. So what I want to tell you, that in case of the abnormal dilatation of central canal, there is the damage of the lateral spinothalamic tract, but anterior spinothalamic tract is normal. So what will happen? Yes, due to this, all the phenomena, loss of pain and temperature. From which side of the body? Definitely from the opposite side of the body. And opposite side of the body means you can use the term contralateral. So the patient is presenting with the contralateral loss of pain and temperature sensation. Suppose the lesion is on the right side, so loss of sensation from the opposite side. We will see again in Brown-Séquard syndrome part. Okay, while the anterior spinothalamic tract is normal. So touch sensation is normal. So now you can see in this condition, totally there are two different types of the situation. In one, there is the loss of pain and temperature, and in the same person, there is the touch sensation is normal. कहने का मतलब एक sensation normal है जबकि दूसरा sensation damage हो गया, abnormal है. तो ऐसे condition को हम कहते हैं dissociative. अलग अलग, that's what dissociative. Anesthesia means loss of sensation, means there is a loss of different kind of the sensation. This is known as dissociative anesthesia. Very most important, this dissociative anesthesia word you will hear in this syringomyelia, as well as you will study in one medicine, one drug, that is the ketamine. So both are MCQs. Syringomyelia, yes, you will study also in physio, in medicine, while the ketamine, which is one of the anesthetic agent, you will study in anesthesia, pharmacology, as well as medicine. Yes, ketamine is very nice kind of the anesthetic agent. It maintains the blood pressure, it maintains the intracranial tension, these all the things. Okay, that's why it is very nice anesthetic agent. Also, it causes the sympathetic stimulation, so it causes bronchodilation. That's why it is very nicely used for the asthmatic patient, any kind of the surgery. Okay, so you will study this all the things. So this is the correlation with the microbiology, with the pharmacology, with the medicine, with the your anesthesia, physiology, various subjects. Okay, this dissociative anesthesia word is also used by the person after the surgery, after the operative procedure, when they are having the anesthesia like ketamine. Okay, so the person, they says it is written in the KD Tripathi that patient will complain that soul have been separated from the body. ऐसा patient बोलेगा कि आत्मा जो है वो शरीर से बाहर निकल गई. Okay, so such kind of the sensations are told by the patient who were under the ketamine. Okay, so these all the things you will study in your clinical subjects. So this is the applied part about the syringomyelia and detail about the lateral spinothalamic tract and anterior spinothalamic tract. Now we are going to see about the dorsal spinocerebellar tract and ventral spinocerebellar tract. What is the function of these two tract important for the MCQs? Yes, these are responsible for the carrying of the subconscious or you can say unconscious kinesthetic sensation. Okay, इसका मतलब क्या है? इसका बहुत बढ़िया सा मतलब फिजियोलॉजी में इस तरीके से आपको समझाया जाएगा कि जब हम चलते हैं तो उस समय हमारा राइट फुट आगे जाता है तब लेफ्ट हैंड आगे की तरफ मूव करता है और वैसे ही जब हम लेफ्ट फुट को आगे बढ़ाते हैं तो ऑटोमेटिक राइट हैंड आगे. सो ड्यूरिंग द वॉकिंग दिस ऑल द प्रोसीजर्स आवर बॉडी एट अनकॉन्शियस ब्रेन डूइंग द काइनेस्थेटिक मूवमेंट एट अनकॉन्शियस ब्रेन. Whatever the kinesis is done, that is the unconscious kinesthetic sensation. There is an entire chapter in physiology you will see. मैं एक दूसरा example आपको समझा रहा हूँ. जब भी हम कोई movement करते हैं तो हमारा body unconscious brain में unconscious level पे कुछ particular posture adopt करता है तब उस movement को properly perform करता है. Suppose आप लिख रहे हैं. So during the writing activity, our thigh is supporting the chair, back is supporting the chair, elbow, wrist, they are supporting the table, we are tilting the head and then we are properly writing. So these all movement, kinesthetic movement are done at subconscious level. Okay, तो इसे हम subconscious kinesthetic sensation कहते हैं, which are carried by dorsal and ventral spinocerebral tract. Break the name, because this tract will run from spinal cord to the cerebellum. That's why spinocerebellar. These are example of lateral white column tract. तो लैटरल साइड में जो पीछे की तरफ होगा दैट इज अ डॉर्सल, जो आगे की तरफ होगा वो वेंट्रल, लेकिन कहां? लैटरल व्हाइट कॉलम में. सो हियर इज द वन इमेज, कैन यू सी? दीज आर स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम द मसल्स एंड द जॉइंट, ओके, वेयर द वेरियस रिसेप्टर्स फॉर अनकॉन्शियस काइनेस्थेटिक सेंसेशंस आर लोकेटेड. तो यहां से आपके फर्स्ट ऑर्डर न्यूरॉन आ रहे हैं, देन दे आर पार्टिसिपेटिंग टू मेक द डॉर्सल रूट गैंग्लियन, देन दीज आर रिलेइंग इनटू द डॉर्सल हॉर्न. ओके, नाउ सी सेकंड ऑर्डर न्यूरॉन यहां से स्टार्ट हुआ, आई एम यूजिंग रेड कलर, एंड देन इट इज रनिंग टू द लैटरल साइड ऑफ द व्हाइट कॉलम, एंड हियर यू सी इट इज मेकिंग द बंडल ऑफ एक्सॉन. तो ये लैटरल व्हाइट कॉलम में है, लेकिन कहां पर है? यस, इट इज लोकेटेड ऑन द पोस्टीरियर साइड. अब यहां से एक्सॉन्स जो हैं वो सीधे सीधे असेंड कर रहे हैं एंड दे आर रनिंग थ्रू द लैटरल पार्ट ऑफ द मेडुला, बट देयर इज नो नीड टू वॉक, नो नीड टू गो थ्रू द पॉन्स और द मिडब्रेन, क्योंकि इसे सेरिबेलम में जाना है. सो इट इज गोइंग टू द सेरिबेलम. नाउ वी विल सी इन द सेरिबेलम देयर इज द सुपीरियर सेरिबेलर पेडंकल, मिडल सेरिबेलर पेडंकल एंड इन्फीरियर सेरिबेलर पेडंकल. इसे सबसे पास पड़ता है इन्फीरियर सेरिबेलर पेडंकल, यहां से ये सेरिबेलम के अंदर एंटर कर जाता है. मींस विद इन दिस पाथवे ओनली टू ऑर्डर न्यूरॉन्स आर लोकेटेड एंड इट इज नॉट द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ क्रॉस्ड ट्रैक्ट, बट इट इज द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ अनक्रॉस्ड ट्रैक्ट. ओके, सो दिस इज द इंफॉर्मेशन. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट द वेंट्रल और एंटीरियर स्पाइनोसेरिबेलर ट्रैक्ट. You can observe this another image for the ventral spinocerebellar tract. Can you see? Again, the first order neuron is coming from the limbs. Okay? Muscles and the joint sensation, they all come. And then they are relaying at the our spinal cord, dorsal horn. Because it's sensory pathway, that's why it will take entry from the dorsal horn. यहाँ पर ये खत्म हो गया. Now, the another neuron is starting, which is the example of second order neuron. Now it is crossing the central canal, midline, and then it is coming opposite side. So this is the example of the crossed tract. Now in the lateral right column, it is making the bundle on the anterior side. Yes, do you remember? Dorsal spinocerebellar tract यहाँ पर होगा, which is uncrossed tract. और ये क्या चीज़ है आपका? Crossed tract. This is the anterior spinocerebellar tract. Also you can say ventral spinocerebellar tract. Now the axons are starting from anterior spinocerebellar tract and they are running above through the medulla. Then it is also reaching to the pons. Then can you see it is also reaching up to the midbrain. तो ये ऊपर तक चला गया, ऊपर तक चला गया. तो जब सेरिबेलम में इसकी एंट्री होगी तो हम फिर से देखते हैं यहाँ पर तीन सेरिबेलर पेडंकल, इन्फीरियर, मिडिल, सुपीरियर. बिकॉज इट इज रीचिंग अप टू द मिड ब्रेन, दैट्स वाई इट विल टेक एंट्री फ्रॉम द मिड ब्रेन. अगेन इट इज क्रॉसिंग. कैन यू सी, एक बार यहाँ क्रॉस किया, एक बार यहाँ क्रॉस किया. सो दिस इज द वेरी रेयर काइंड ऑफ द ट्रैक विच इज क्रॉसिंग द मिड लाइन फॉर द टू टाइम्स एंड नाउ इट इज रीचिंग अप टू द सेरिबेलम. अगेन इट इज हैविंग द ओनली टू ऑर्डर न्यूरॉन. It is the example of the cross tract for the two times, okay? But it is entering on the same side, okay? तो इसका क्या काम है? Unconscious kinesthetic sensation को carry करना. So this is all about this spinocerebellar tract. After the completion of the various ascending tracts, now we are going to see what is the descending tract. As earlier in our description part we have seen descending tract which runs from brain to down towards the spinal cord, they are known as descending tract. Now try to understand, when there is the impulse generation in the brain, then they will send signal to the spinal cord, and from the spinal cord they will send signal to our peripheral part. So there is the activity in the hand. So that's why these descending tracts are also known as motor tract. Now these motor tract or descending tracts, they are two types, either the pyramidal tract or the extra pyramidal tract. So now we are going to understand what is the meaning of pyramidal tract and what is the meaning of extra pyramidal tract. Suppose this dilated bulb like structure is the medulla. At center there is a central canal and gray matter and the white matter. We will see medulla after this topic. That medulla is nothing, it is the upper continuation of the spinal cord. So from the front view of the medulla, there is the one central elevation is seen, which is known as pyramid, while the lateral elevation is seen, which is known as olive. Now descending tracts are coming down and they are passing from medulla. तो ऐसा tract जो pyramid से होकर के पास होता है, can you see? Passing through the pyramid, known as the pyramidal tract. This pyramidal tract, they are crossing at the lower part to the opposite side, and maximum number of the fibers they are reaching to the lateral side of the spinal cord. So these tracts which are coming from above to the down, they are motor tract and passing from the pyramid. That's why known as the pyramidal tract. And you can also observe that these pyramidal tracts, they are crossing together at the midline, at the lower part of the medulla. This crossing of the pyramidal tract is known as pyramidal decussation. Because you know this pyramidal tract is the motor tract, that's why this pyramidal decussation is also known as motor decussation. So this is very important point as well as MCQ for Viva. Now see, there are other tracts also which are passing outside the pyramid. So these tracts which are passing outside the pyramid, they are known as extra pyramidal tract. Again, this extra pyramidal tract two types. Yes, extra pyramidal tract stimulatory, while the extra pyramidal tract inhibitory. You will study better in physiology what is the function of the extra pyramidal tract, just to support the pyramidal tract. So any kind of the activity performed by the pyramidal tract, yes, what is the function of pyramidal tract? It is responsible for the motor activity. So the motor activity is supported by the extra pyramidal tract. Any kind of the movement, any kind of voluntary movement in our body is done by the pyramidal tract, and it is supported by the extra pyramidal tract. So पिरामिडल ट्रैक्ट जो भी काम कर रहा है उसे स्टिमुलेट करने का काम कौन करेगा? एक्स्ट्रा पिरामिडल ट्रैक्ट स्टिमुलेटरी, जबकि उसको इनहिबिट करके बैलेंस करने का काम कौन करेगा? एक्स्ट्रा पिरामिडल ट्रैक्ट इनहिबिटरी. वी विल सी लेटर इन डिटेल. एंड यू कैन ऑल्सो ऑब्जर्व इन दिस इमेज दैट दिस पिरामिडल ट्रैक्ट इज कमिंग फ्रॉम द कॉर्टेक्स, दैट्स वाई दिस इज नोन एज कॉर्टिको, एंड इट इज गोइंग टू द स्पाइनल कॉर्ड, दैट्स वाई स्पाइनल बंडल ऑफ एक्सॉन, दैट्स वाई नोन एज द ट्रैक्ट. नाउ सी द मैक्सिमम पार्ट ऑफ दिस फाइबर्स, मैक्सिमम पार्ट ऑफ दिस फाइबर्स दे आर रीचिंग टू द लैटरल साइड ऑफ द स्पाइनल कॉर्ड. सो दिस बंडल ऑफ एक्सॉन विल बी नोन एज लैटरल कॉर्टिको स्पाइनल ट्रैक्ट. While very few fibers they are not crossing and they reaches to the entry part of the spinal cord, that will make the bundle of another group, that will be known as anterior corticospinal tract. Means corticospinal tract two types, lateral corticospinal tract and anterior corticospinal tract. So we are going to see in detail about this all the things. So, what is the classification of motor tract or descending tract, or you can say efferent tract? It is two types, pyramidal tract and extra pyramidal tract. Okay, now the pyramidal tract is two type. Approximately 80%, few books also mentions like the 70%, 75% fibers crosses opposite and forms lateral corticospinal tract, while 20% of the fibers they are uncrossed and they are running on the anterior part of the spinal cord, so known as anterior corticospinal tract. Now try to understand extrapyramidal tract on the basis of their function. They are extrapyramidal tract stimulatory or extrapyramidal tract inhibitory. But what are the various tracts according to their location? We have already seen in transverse section of the spinal cord showing various tracts, but just for your notes we are writing here. We have written one tree, R, two times O, V and the T. R for, yes, rubro spinal tract. R for reticulo spinal tract, again it was divided into the lateral and medial reticulo spinal tract. O for olivo spinal tract. V for vestibulo spinal tract. T for tecto spinal tract. Okay, so these are the various descending and the motor tracts. Now we are going to see in detail the pyramidal tract, which is very important. Okay, because on the basis of this pyramidal tract description, we will be able to understand the upper and the lower motor neuron paralysis.